support rather than to complain about the rain. It's time that we learn to dance in it.
Addressing issues that matter.
When we look at what our baseline is, folks, on this show, it is a baseline to bring newsmakers together.
And now, your host, Robert Christian.
And we are back. All right, everyone. Okay, today's live show, it is mind-boggling. And part of it, I'm sure, will cause you to really think twice about this. And a company that has perpetually refused to raise the prices by 1 cent on products that they sell in order to give healthcare and a reasonable healthcare coverage to every single employee. Or this one company who could raise the price of every item sold by 1.1 cent in order to give every employee a living wage to help them to get out of poverty, to help them from having to depend on assistance from food stamps just to be able to live, and to get them into their own homes, to grow the economy across the board. We're going to be getting into that part of this story on today's live show. But here we are in hour number one. Retail sales unexpectedly fell in April as households cut back on purchases of vehicles and a range of other goods, reflecting a slowdown in the economic growth after a temporary boost from exports and inventories in the first quarter of this year. Donald Trump, he has upped the ante on his tariffs with China, and he has consistently argued that consumers, they shouldn't be worried. Trump has slapped China with a 25% tariff on $200 billion of goods and floated the possibility of tariffs on $325 billion in addition, or into additional Chinese goods. China, meanwhile, is prepared to impose retaliatory tariffs on $60 billion of American products. Can I go on? In the remarks at the White House on May the 9th, Trump said, in quotation, and you can challenge this, and I hope that you do, because you will find that I'm telling you the truth. He said, in quotation, our country can take in $120 billion a year in tariffs, paid for mostly by China, by the way, and not by us. A lot of people try to steer it in a different direction. It's really paid for largely by China. And businesses will pour back into our country, ex quote. Now, there is a big problem with this. Now, do you guys, all of the fans of the show, all of the podcast listeners, everybody, I want you to be vocal and as vocal as that you can be. Should I eat this up right now, or should I tear it up right now? Well, so our country can take $120 billion in tariffs, paid for mostly by China. And by the way, not by us. Okay, wait. I don't know when the last time was that Donald Trump went to a grocery store, or the last time that he actually looked and understood exactly what the what his tariff on China actually is. On what products exactly? Well, I've got a list. But the huge list is over 137 pages long of items that are involved in this tariff. But he said it's going to be paid for largely by China. I assume the same way that Mexico is going to end up paying for the border wall. Next. It is inaccurate to say that the countries pay the tariffs on commercial and consumer goods. It is the buyers and sellers that bear the cost of this. And that is a fact. Ross Burkhardt, a Boise State University political scientist, says, in quotation, purchasers pay for the tariff when they buy popular products. Sellers lose the market share when their products get priced out of the markets. Lower income Americans tend to spend a large fraction of their income on goods. They would feel the pinch worse than the more affluent Americans do. Meanwhile, back on Pennsylvania Avenue, Donald Trump, he increased the tariffs on $200 billion worth of Chinese imports to 25% from 10% as of last week. The move is widely expected to raise prices on thousands of products. Now, before I go into it, I had asked a good question a couple of days ago on social media. Now, I don't know if you are one of the lucky ones that caught it. If you are, thank you very much on both sides of this whole deal for your responses. But I had asked the question, is our economy, is it doing well? I think perhaps for business owners, perhaps it's doing better. Is it where it should be? No. But who is ultimately paying the price for the massive tax breaks to the ultra billionaires in the states and these ultra large companies that make products overseas and sell them overseas, and yet they have a post office box on Main Street. And because of that one post office box on Main Street, they can get the multi-million dollar or a billion dollar tax credit just for saying, oh, well, we're based in the United States. There's something wrong. $200 billion is what we're talking about. China retaliated on Monday, announcing that it would raise tariffs on some $60 billion in American-made imports. Now, who is this actually hurting? Let's take a mental trip to the Midwest, where farmers that raise soybeans, farmers that raise corn, farmers that raise wheat and barley, these kind of agricultural products, not even to mention the farmers in the Southwest who grow their tomatoes, who grow the okra and the spinach and all of the stuff. And here they are in the midst of this turmoil as well. So are the farmers losing out? Yes. Now, let's get ready to get a little bit aggravated. A big box store, Walmart, the chief financial officer, Brett Biggs, told Reuters news agency that higher tariffs would result in increased prices for consumers. Okay, I get this. He said, let's go back to what Donald Trump said. He said that China would mostly be paying for this tariff. Mostly. Well, mostly, if that was the case, then what Walmart's chief financial officer, Brett Biggs, said, then is a lie. As Brett Biggs told Reuters that higher prices will result in increased prices for consumers, he said that the company will seek to ease the pain, in part by trying to obtain products from different countries and by working with suppliers. Cost structures to manage higher tariffs. But then we have Charlie O'Shea. Moody's analyst, Charlie O'Shea, said that the potential impact on Walmart alone and its shoppers from tariffs is limited to its food business, its grocery operation, which includes fresh food, contributes roughly to 56% of Walmart's overall annual revenue. Okay, so we're getting one thing from the White House, and we're getting something else from someone who is in the field, who works in that industry, who understands that industry perhaps more than, Pennsylvania Avenue. Now, a new study, true, and do look it up. A new study commissioned by the Coke Industries. First time that I have ever said that. A new study commissioned by the Coke Industries conducted a consulting firm, Impact Econ. Impact, Econ. And they looked at the potential cumulative impact of tariffs. And here are some of the effects that we can look forward to. Thank you, Pennsylvania Avenue, as if America wasn't hurting enough. Now, this is going, I don't care, folks, if you shop at Walmart, if you shop at Target, if you shop at other places, other stores, mom and pop stores, for your groceries or for your blue jeans. No matter where you shop, you are going to be affected. What about the restaurant industry? Is this going to mean the food prices are going to go up? Yeah. That's what I've been saying. That's what I'm talking about. Spot on target, Maynard. How do you like that? In 2019, households will suffer losses equivalent to $2,357 per household or $915 per person in 2017 dollars. The year 2017. Now, the gross domestic product, or the GDP, would be reduced by the projected minus 1.78% in 2009. Now you got to be a mathematician. Okay, just follow me. Or $365.1 billion in 2017 dollars, and the GDP losses are projected to let's see, they are projected to a discounted value of $2.8 trillion between 2018 and 2030. All countries except the United States and China gained from the U.S. trade actions, responses, and increased GDP. All countries except the United States and China gain from these trade actions. Now, I don't have to be a brain scientist to figure this out. Here we are the ones paying. You and I are the ones paying for these in this trade war. But we're not gaining from the trade war. Everybody else is, except the U.S. and China. Doesn't that tell you that something is wrong? Ah, I got it. In 2019, an estimated, if I can speak, 2.75 million workers are likely to become unemployed if all trade actions are implemented concurrently. A high proportion of these job losses affect the agricultural and low-skilled workers. In addition to those that are unemployed, 665,000 workers are expected to be displaced in 2019 and must find employment in new industries. By 2030, 1.7 million workers will be employed in a different sector because of the trade actions alone. Next year, the Trump tariffs are expected to cost the Americans, you and me, the Americans, $915 each, or $2,400 per household in the form of higher prices. Get this, get ready for it. Lower wages and lower investment. They could also wipe out more jobs than ever were created in 2017, by the way, which was 2.1 million. A foreign country. Now, if a foreign country were to cause us such substantial economic losses, we would consider that an act of war. We would never tolerate such an action, especially when it harms Americans most vulnerable, the poor, the low-skilled workers. Then why then are we not outraged when our own government does it? That is a question for you. Folks, I have more. Now, we want to get into some of these products that are involved in this trade war, in this tariff, the tit for tat in tariffs. There were 297 items removed from the USTR's initial list, which was released last July, almost a year ago, after the public comment period. But here we go. Here is a list. The initial list. And these items were removed from, like I said, they were removed. Let me go up. You can read it right there. They'll remove from the USDR's initial list, released in July. Here we go. After the public comment period. These include certain consumer electronics, including smartwatches. Ooh, everybody wants one. And Bluetooth devices. Most people anymore, they need those, right? Certain industrial chemicals used for manufacturing textiles. Certain. Notice the words certain. Health and safety products, including bicycle helmets. Certain ones, but it didn't say which ones. Okay. Certain types. I love this. Of child safety furniture, including high chairs and car seats. Certain types. The USDR did not specifically, USTR did not specifically or specify how he determined which of these products were removed beyond, assertions that the local or that the official followed an interagency procedure. Okay. Even with the removals, 5,745 dollars and full or partial tariffs. Tariff lines are included on the final list, represented roughly $200 billion worth of Chinese imports. Oh, so now you guys want to get the gist of it. Oh, see how you are? Now I've got your attention here. Now remember, these are the things that I just gone through. Those things were removed from the initial list. But now here is the breakdown of the major categories included. I got to say that in this list. And I'm doing this just to educate you. Now, I don't know about you, but when the U.S., when we had our last election, we're electing someone, or someone was elected that was to be representing America and its common issues, its common core, and to keep America moving forward. Ah, instead, it has been a tit for tat when it comes to Congress. When it comes to the Mueller report, when it comes to the climate, now when it comes to the tariff, this is all boiling over. Here we go. Let's have fun. Here's a breakdown of the major categories included: meat, pork, beef, intestines, rabbit meat, venison, frog legs. True. Fish and seafood, live fish, including ornamental fish, trout, eels, tuna, carp. All of these kind of things. If you buy a can of tuna at Walmart or any other store, the cost of that tuna is going to go up. One, because it lists the product as being tuna, right? So that's going to make the cost of it go up. And then, oh, let's not forget the metal, the tin tariffs that are also in place. So you are tariffed again because of the can that your tuna would be in. Carp, chilled or frozen meat, various types of trout, salmon. Let's see. Herring, mackerel. Okay, swordfish, catfish, rays, and more. Okay, that's all in it. Non-meat animal products, such as eggs and dairy. Whey products, butter, various types of eggs, including various types of eggs, including chicken eggs, honey eggs, hair of animals, including human. hair of animals, including human. So now you're talking about wigs, hog, horse, and badger. Animal, okay. You guys get this, right? I mean, I'm not going to sit here and read verbatim every single thing, but you guys can get it. I mean, parts of this is a little bit questionable. Vegetables, onions, garlic, cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, carrots, turnips, radishes. All of these kind of things are ultimately going to be affected by these tariffs. Squash, okra, yum. Sweet corn, potatoes, sweet potatoes, and yams. Some types of tomatoes, spinach, Brussels sprouts. Look. Okay. This is part of the list. That's what I'm telling you. This is all part of the list. You can't go to the store without a list. Fruits and nuts, coconuts, cashews, almonds, hazelnuts, walnuts, chestnuts, pistachios, macadamia nuts, pecans, dates, figs, pineapples, oranges, mandarins, yep, the clementines, raisins, grapes, apples. You guys get it? All this is going to be affected. Even if these products do not originate in China, but they originate in the United States, oh, well, guess who's going to be paying a tariff? You are. Cereals, including drum wheat, barley, oats, corn, various types of rice, grain, buckwheat, and more. What kind of report is that says and more? Come on, folks. Get real. Meal products, flours, including those from wheat, corn, buckwheat, rice, rye, or other cereals, potatoes, bananas, goats, and meal of various types, including wheat, corn. Oh, okay, you guys get this? Do you guys get the picture? Oil seeds. Oh, the list goes on. Like I said, there's 137 pages of it in this one report. Oil seeds, soybeans, sunflower seeds, flax seeds, sesame. Okay. Sugars and candies. Cane sugar, candies with no coca. No cacao. If you don't know what cacao is, you should look it up. Breads and pasta. Uncooked pasta, various breads, pastries, cakes, and biscuits. Now leave my biscuits alone. I mean, I'm like, please. Leave those biscuits alone. Prepared vegetables and fruits. Oh, so that means if you are going to buy a can of this little mixture stuff, what do you call it? It's in a can. You buy it. And it has some good stuff in it. It's healthy, or it's what it is. Little fruits and little vegetables in a little can, you see. Including your pineapple. Oh, and much more. Many more little things. There'll be a tariff. Other food items. Now, folks, I'm showing you this because I want you to be educated as to what this says. Soy sauce, okay, condiments, seasonings, protein, concentrates, beverages, and vinegars. Water, number one. Okay, there's going to be a tariff on bottled water, including mineral water, fruit or vegetable juices, juice mixes, beer from malt, wine, including rice, wine, alcohol, and vinegars. Okay, the mighty vinegars. Okay, food processing, waste, and animal feed. Okay, I'm not going to read that. Processing oil, cakes, dog food, cat food, animal food, even your doggy and your kitty is going to, their food and their upkeep is going to cost at least a little bit more. Tobacco products, various types of preparations of tobacco, tobacco refuse, cigarettes, cigars, smoking tobacco, is all in this. Okay, yeah, and then I hear people say, oh, well, people shouldn't be smoking. People shouldn't be dipping tobacco. People shouldn't be doing that kind of stuff because that's nasty. That's horrifying. Okay, they shouldn't be doing that. Okay, then, well, maybe we should just stop eating as a nation. Look, I mean, seriously, look at this. Salts and minerals. Salt, sodium, sulfur, graphite, quartz, types of clays, chalk. Uh-oh, look out, school districts. Slate, marble, granite. Oh, boy, so you're gonna put new marble and granite in your kitchen? In your bathrooms at home or your motorhome? You want nice granite tabletops and all this stuff going on? Well, guess what? That's going to be tariffed, too. This tariff, it isn't what it's becoming is a tit for a tat. But at no time in American history has our economy balanced back or bounced back because solely of tariffs. Never. That is not the intention of these tariffs. So I want to know, with these tariffs, who is ultimately going to pay for it? I think we all know the answer. Now, I'm going to keep going on with this list. Oh, trust me, there is far more to this list. Hey, folks, this program, by the way, it is sponsored by viewers and supporters just like you. Interactive Newsmakers interviews. And now, by your gift to robertchristianshow.com/donate, we can continue on with shows just like this, educating the masses. And you can be a part of that. Thank you for your time, your consideration, giving, and ultimately, your support. Now, we're going to continue here. Ores, slag, and ash. Ores of iron. That's what it says. Copper. Ooh. Nickel. Okay. Cobalt. Aluminum. Oh, let me show this to you. Let me just show this right here. Now, remember what I had said about the can of tuna? Well, tuna was listed in this same document under a different heading. And now we've run into this one. Aluminum, lead, zinc, tin. Okay, tungsten, uranium, titanium, silver, and other precious metals. And others, slag, various types of ash. That's what it says. Isn't that what that word right there says? Ash. Okay. So now what we're having is a tariff on what's inside of the can. Like if it's tuna, if it's fish, if some other kind of fish beyond tuna, if it is okra in a can, anything in a can, basically, you're going to have a tariff on what's inside of the can, and then you're going to have a tariff on the can itself. Now you're like, oh, come on, Robert, that's not really what that says. Yeah, it does. And I'm sticking to it. Now, this is ridiculous. Folks, this is absolutely a tit for tat when it comes to the tariffs, when it comes to this mess, because Donald Trump got so angry at China. Now, granted, what China has been doing against the United States and charging the tariffs on American goods for years hasn't been right. Intellectual property rights have been disputed. But yet, on top of all of this, now this is going to put the belt buckle on your belt for you. On top of all this, there are American companies who now are based in China. There are auto manufacturing companies that either make automobiles or parts for them that are based in China. They have perhaps a world headquarters in the United States, so they can get some tax relief. But then they have the companies themselves, the factories overseas. So you're going to be paying a tariff on a product made by an American company, but just because it was made overseas, well, you get it. You're still going to have to pay the tariff. Mineral fuels and oils, coal, coke tars, various types of light oil, various types of kerosene, petroleum oils, all of this as well. So you're thinking about living off the grid, and I mean, come on. You want to have the go back to the kerosene days where no electricity, and you just had your kerosene little lamp, and in the middle of the winter, you'd go out to the outhouse carrying your kerosene lamp and think it's great to live off grid because you don't have a power bill. Come on. Well, your kerosene then is involved in this tariff as well. Organic chemicals are in it. Fertilizers, animal or vegetable fertilizers. Let's see, sodium nitrate and more are in it. Tanning and drying extracts, dyes and paints are in this. Essential oils and perfumes, lip and eye makeup are in this. Products used for manicures or pedicure products, shampoo, hairspray, bath salts, all of this. Oh, yes, it's all in it. Soap and cleaning products. So the only way that you're going to be able to live and not be affected by these is if you don't buy anything at a grocery store, or anything, period. You don't need your clothes clean. You don't need lighter fluid. You don't need any glues. Oh, by the way, glues are also in this. You don't have a phone. You don't take photos. So no matter what the photo plates are, the instant film, various types of film in rolls, various types of motion picture film, you don't go to a movie anyway. So by humbug, okay, you don't go to the store. You don't have to eat anything. Okay, you're living off the grid. That's a great thing, right? Then maybe you'll be safe from all this. Ah, but just in case. You don't know. Plastics, vinyl flooring, and other plastic flooring and wall coverings. Sausage casings, bags, gloves, including baseball gloves, rain jackets, and machinery belts, like for your lawnmower or for your vacuum cleaner at home, are all in this. Oh, it's okay. I'll just use something else. Well, forget it. Rubber, latex rods, tubes, and other products, conveyor belts, various types of transmission belts, various types of tires, gloves, gaskets, and dock fenders. Oh, yes, they're all in this with the tariff. Raw hides and other leather, animal skins, including cow, buffalo, sheep, goats, reptile, various types of leather made from cow, buffalo, sheep, goats, or reptile. Leather trunks, suitcases, leather handbags, CD cases, gloves, including skis, hockey, ice hockey, typical use belts for fur clothing, including artificial fur. It's all going to be tariffed. Wood fuel, charcoal, various types of wood, including oak, beech, maple, ash, cherry. Now, I know, right now you're like, you know what, this is really boring. I'm telling you what the report says. The bottom line, and folks, this goes on and on and on. Bottom line here is this. We are all going to be affected by this tariff. Cotton. Man-made textiles, fabrics, corduroy, gauze, terry towel, lace, badges, embroidery, stone, plaster, cement, asbestos, ceramics, like bricks and pipes and tiles or porcelain and china, oh my, glassware, copper plates, cables, tubes, pipes. So that means that it's going to cost you 25% more if you have to do electrical work in your home or in a new project. Nickel, bars, rods, wires, aluminum, cable wire, screws, it's all going to cost you a little bit more. Electronics, vacuum cleaners, hair dryer, clippers, spark plugs, oh my. Generators, bicycle lights, electric amps, television cameras, various types of TVs and video projectors. Okay. Parachutes. That's in here. Ships and boats, sailboats, motorboats, canoes, and yachts. It's in here. Clocks and watches, you bet, furniture, assorted items. And folks, that is just the beginning of that list. Now, having said that, folks, what do you think about it? I want to sit and scream. Because America is better than this. We are seeing an absolute freight train disaster that's going on right now. And I think that what's happening is that America has been fooled. Fooled by bad politics, fooled by a bad leader, fooled by bad intentions, and lied to make up for it. When we look at what the tariffs are, the products, by name, mind you, and we look at what these tariffs are, it should really anger you. Now, let me go as far to help you to understand as this. 508-709-5483, our live call in line. If you have something that you'd like to voice, please call us and voice your opinion, your thought on today's live show. 508-709-5483. Okay, here is the deal. One company could raise the cost of every product that they sell by 1.1 cent per item. And as a result of that, that one company would be able to give every employee a living wage. So they are not in need to have and to depend on food stamps, to depend on public assistance for medication, or any of that stuff. They then would be able to get people and bring people from poverty, living in poverty, to living and having a job at a living wage. And they so far have refused. The $15 an hour minimum wage, that's a start. But I don't know of any state in the union where you can work a typical 40 hours a week at $15 an hour and be able to keep a roof over your head and a two-bedroom apartment, car payments, credit card payments, utility bills, all this. That becomes a moot deal, right? Because you can't do it on $15 an hour. I think that the federal minimum wage should go up. Absolutely. But one company doesn't depend on the minimum wage other than for a floor of what the scrapings are off the floor that they can actually get by legally and pay their employees with. But yet we have lawmakers, elected officials, who are against the federal minimum wage, who think that the federal minimum wage should go away. They think that the federal minimum wage is a nuisance, and it should be outlawed. So you could get paid whatever that your employer thinks that you're worth, if it's a penny an hour, or if it's a dollar an hour, or a salary of $2 a month. Well, that's preposterous, Robert Christian. Well, of course it is. You can't do it. So this tariff, what it's going to do, it is going to hurt the poor, those that depend on food stamps, those that depend on public assistance. It is going to hurt them more than others. Since when does a rich man, highfalutin rich man, since when does he need and want a simple peanut butter sandwich? Not that often. Since when do they open up a can of tuna fish and make tuna fish sandwiches at home and say, hey, that's lunch? Most likely, not that often. So Sharon brings up a good point. Wait, why raise prices? Why not use some of the gazillion dollars in profits to pay their employees a decent wage? Talking about the box store. Sharon, great question. This is my response. First, because if they rose the price of each product by 1.1 cent. That is all. A-L-L. That is it. That shows you how big they are. This company. But if they rose the price by 1.1% on every single product, then the family and the shareholders of that company would not suddenly be going poor, because the company, its actual revenues are tanked out because of the employees getting a living wage. So if their bottom line is the almighty dollar, so they want to keep their dollars. But if every single product sold was 1.1 cent higher, of course, every employee would be able to have a living wage. And if you add another cent, so 2 cents per every item sold could give these employees free health care paid for through the company. And we're talking about 1.4 million employees. I think it's about what it is. 1.5 million. So they would have health care paid for by the company. They would also get a living wage. But in most cases, though, people that work in box stores like that, they don't work a 40-hour week, because if they did, or 37 hours, because if they did, that would mean that they would be entitled to full-time benefits, which includes health care, vacation time, sick days, all this stuff. And so a way, a legal loophole for them to jump through is just to reduce down the amount of hours that a worker gets. And to me, it's sad, because with companies like that, their bottom line is their almighty dollar, and what can they get on the almighty dollar. Sharon says, I'm on a fixed income. Better their employee salaries come out of the profits than my Social Security check. Well, quite a skept, Sharon. And this is would be a great subject for a future show. It really would. But Social Security, we're talking about draining the swamp, draining the system, or adding to the mayhem. Social Security, it adds nothing to the federal deficit, to the national debt. It never did. It wasn't created that way. But yet we have right-wing fanatics that are in Congress and in the U.S. Senate that would say otherwise, and they want to close up shop on Medicare and Medicaid, and Social Security, to get all of the money out of these trust funds and spend it willy-nilly and give it to the military. You know what we spend in America? 57% of our national debt every year, our national income rather, is spent on the military. No other nation on this earth does that, nor has any nation ever done that, except for the United States. That is ridiculous. So being on a fixed income, I can understand it. But I also understand that with these tariffs, those that are on fixed incomes, those that have very little to begin with, those are the exact people that these tariffs are going to hurt the worst. And Donald Trump making the declaration, well, China is going to pay for, well, most of it. No, they're not. So where then are all of these billions, $200 billion, where is all of this going to go? Is this real money, or is this make-believe money on a Monopoly board? But if it's real money, then where is this money going to go? Is it going to go to offset Social Security? Oh, Lord, now wouldn't that be great? $200 billion a year added to the Social Security Trust Fund. Could you imagine? Hey, could that go into another program to help seniors pay their bills, including their credit card bills? Do you think that it would go into a no. Never. Possibly. Oh, that is just not right. It's not going to go there. So, as Jane says, the rich get richer and screw the poor. You know, years ago, Jane, in China, and I remember, I did a study on it several years ago. And the study was on multi-generational households, because back then that was something that would only happen like in China. You'd hear it about China and you'd say, wow, you know, there's a lot of people that are living multi-generational households in China. You know, we're seeing that today in the United States, and people these days are having a very hard time with their bills. But if you own a home, be grateful for that, because you are one of the few. It's ridiculous. And so all of the signs, however, are pointing to what a lot of Americans don't want to admit, and that is a recession. And our economy is not doing that well to be able to offset and to be able to prolong a recession if Wall Street tanked. It's not strong enough as a country to be able to keep going no matter what Wall Street does, because America has become so dependent upon it. I know it's two different things. Is our economy strong? Yes, it is strong, but it could be stronger. But what needs to be done realistically, rather than giving all the tax breaks to the millionaires and to the billionaires, but to everyone else, their tax break would expire in 5 years. Come on. And it's going to. I think that all signs are pointing toward an eventual recession. Are we ready for it? Folks, I'm Robert Christian, and this is the Robert Christian Show, where your voice, your opinion, they do matter. With interactive newsmakers, that is exactly what we are about. And give us a ring. Give us a call, 508-709-5483. And reminding you, ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to help to support your interactive show, by robertchristianshow.com/donate, that does help us to stay on the air and stay lively. Folks, in the meantime, it is a joy having you all tuned in on today's live show. Don't forget next week. Oh boy, I'm already working on next week's show. Yes, I am. I can't let the bag out just yet on what is going on for next week. But it surely will be a show you don't want to miss. We'll see you next time.